Good morning class. As we have started with the explanation of chapter 3, that is food and health. Now today we are going to continue with the explanation of that one. As yesterday we have read the topic balanced diet. And today we are going to start with the exercise which is being given over here. It's an activity that today we are going to do that. Now before starting that, let me give you a short revision about what is a balanced diet. Balanced diet, a diet which we take. It's a kind of food that which we eat is our diet. And balanced diet is a diet we can say when it have complete 5 nutrients. That when a balanced diet is complete, when it is having all the 5 nutrients. That are water and roughage, vitamins and minerals, fats. These are all nutrients. When a diet is having all these, that is called a complete balanced diet. And we have read about the pyramid of a balanced diet. And when we move from bottom to top, the pyramid has been becoming lesser and lesser, because at the bottom there is more. At the bottom the quantity should be taken more than when we move above. At the bottom there is a great quantity than that as we move to the top of the pyramid. Now let us do the exercise based on balanced diet. And now today we are going to start with two another topics, that are exercise and rest and the diseases. So let us begin with the explanation of the today's topic. This is on page number 33. So open to page number 33 in your books. Now, as I've told you that today we are going to continue with chapter 3 only, from page number 33. As yesterday we have read the chapter till here, and I hope the balanced diet is clear to all of you. Now before starting this exercise, let me tell you what is a balanced diet. Balanced diet is a diet that we eat, and it has different food items. The different food items should contain adequate amount of 5 nutrients, that are carbohydrates, fats, water and roughage, vitamins and minerals. This all should be included in the balanced diet. Then if we take all the 5 nutrients, then we are taking the complete balanced diet. Now this is an exercise which is based on balanced diet only. Now let us begin with the exercise today. Checkpoint. It's lunch time and Ria's mother has served her lunch. It is the lunch time and Ria's mother has served her lunch. Let's see what she is having for lunch. And you have to see what she is having for lunch. Do you think her lunch is a balanced meal? If you think that her lunch is a balanced meal, write reason behind the answer. Write your reason. If you think that Ria is eating a complete balanced diet, you have to give one reason for that. If needed, add or delete food items to make it balanced. If you need to delete some of the items, to cut some of the items, you can do that also. Now, curd. There are many things given over here. First one is buttermilk, pulses. Pulses mean dal, curd, salad, rajma, potatoes, bread and butter, rice, roti, apple and mango. Now you can see, I have put the tick on only 5 items over here, which she would eat in lunch. Curd, salad, rajma, rice and roti. These 5 food items contain all the 5 types of nutrients. Instead of curd, you can put a tick on the buttermilk. Instead of rajma, you can put a tick on the pulses. Instead of roti, you can put the tick on the potatoes. Then too, it will be a complete meal. But because I have taken rajma, then I have not taken pulses. I have taken curd. Because of that, I have not taken buttermilk. You can change it according to yours. Now, let us write the reason for it. Yes, her lunch is a balanced meal. as it includes all the five nutrients that constitute a balanced diet. Yes, I can say that his lunch is a complete balanced meal because it includes all the five nutrients which constitute to a balanced diet. You have to write this reason over here at the in the lines given below. Now, let us begin with a new topic, exercise and rest. To stay fit, we need to do exercise. If we want to remain fit and our body should remain healthy, then too, we need to do exercise and keep our muscles toned. During exercise, our heart beat at a faster rate. When we do exercise, our heart beats faster. As the rate heart beats faster, more blood circulates in the body. As our heart beats faster, then more of the blood circulates in our body and our brain gets more oxygen. Our muscles become stronger as we move them. We must sleep for at least 8 hours every day to give our body enough rest and relax our muscles. We must sleep for 8 hours, at least 8 hours in a day to give our body enough rest and relax our muscles. Sound sleep also gives our body time to grow and repair. When we sleep soundly, some of the people you have seen that while sleeping time they made a sound from their mouth. That sound sleep gives our body time to grow and repair. It gives time to our brain too, and it gives time to the brain also. We wake up cheerfully if we rest and sleep well at night. We will wake up cheerfully when we get a proper sleep at night. We will get up with a charming day, and if we sleep properly 8 hours in a day, then we will wake up cheerfully. Now turn the page and move to page number 34. Now I hope the topic exercise and rest is clear to all of you. Now today we are going to start with the other topic also, that is diseases and its types. Diseases are the bad conditions by which our body and mind are not able to function properly because they diseases are caused when we have lack of nutrition. Diseases are caused because of the lack of nutrition and deficiency of vitamins. Diseases are caused by mainly it is called by the deficiency of nutrients. Diseases and its type. Diseases is an abnormal condition during which our body and mind are not able to function properly. Because of diseases, it's an abnormal condition in our body because due to diseases, our body is not able, our body and mind even are not able to function properly. Diseases can occur due to lack of proper nutrition, due to infection by any pathogen, improper functioning of an organ, and due to aging and various other factors. Diseases can occur because of proper nutrition, infection by any pathogen, improper functioning of an organ we can say eyes, liver, because of that also, or due to aging and various other factors. Because of various other factors, diseases can occur in our body. Diseases are of two types, that is communicable diseases and non-communicable disease. There are two types of diseases which we are going to read about in further class, that are communicable diseases and non-communicable. Communicable diseases are those diseases which can spread from one person to other person. That is fungus, we can say virus, like we can say COVID, that is happening from one person to other. This is also a communicable disease. Non-communicable diseases are those diseases that cannot spread or cannot be transferred from one person to other person. They cannot be spread from one person to other person. They will they are called non-communicable diseases. Now I hope the chapter till here, diseases and its type, is clear to all of you. Homework for you all is to, you just have to read this chapter thoroughly. If you have any doubts regarding this topic, exercise and rest, and diseases and its type, you can ask me. Thank you.